That made it impossible for all of us to be alive at this point in time, to give honor to whom honor is due, to show respect and to honor our fallen heroes and heroines. We say to our fallen heroes and heroines, as we honor them today, may they also honor us in return. As we, the indigenous people of Biafra, have recognized the ultimate sacrifice they paid, they gave their life for us to live. They died. They choose suffering. They choose death. They choose humiliation because of us. Because of the sacrifices they made for us, that's why we are alive today. And we are assuring the world that the price our ancestors, our heroes and heroines paid on our behalf will never be in vain. We must uphold that freedom they fought for. We must uphold that freedom they died for. We must uphold that liberty they crave for. Whether in death, whether in life, as long as we are alive, as long as we still have men that are living on this geographical area called Biafra, we must remember our heroes and heroines come every 30th of May of every year in the name of Chukwu Abiama. We have dedicated today for them. And we are asking them, both small and great, men and women, children that are stabbed to death. We are asking them today that the price they paid is not in vain. That we will continue from where they stopped. No power on earth will defeat Biafra. No power on earth will stop us. Who crush our enemies? Who overrun our enemies? The spirit of Biafra will prevail above every other spirit. Any nation that says Biafra will not stand, we will overrun. We have volunteered ourselves to die for Biafra to be restored. We are not shaking. We are not afraid of our enemies. Our leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, have urged us to remain resolute, to remain fearless before our enemies. And we must remain fearless before our enemies. Our men are aware that are here today. Be courageous, because we are winning the war. Be courageous, because the battle is coming to an end. Be courageous, because at the end, we must win. Biafra must win. Biafra must emerge. Whether enemies like it or not. Most of us have paid the utmost price since 2013, since 2015, 16, 17, 18, and even some have paid in 2019. We are remembering them today. We have somebody in our midst, our beloved brother, Miracle Dorfia, known as Immortal. Wherever you are, Immortal, the people you left behind, they are still standing resolute. Because of your death, we must fight on. Because of your death, we must restore Biafra for you. Our brother Chibuzo, you have paid your ultimate price. You have laid down your life for thousands to live. Today, we honor you. Today, we celebrate you. You're a brave soldier. Our brother Richard John, wherever you are, we say may your spirit be at peace with us. May he never be at peace with your enemies. May he never be at peace with your murderers. People that murdered you. Because of your deaths, because you stand gladly defending your station, because you stand gladly defending those that cannot defend themselves, we draw strength. We draw courage from that sacrifice we paid on that first few days to Paul. Rest on, brother. We that you have left behind, we are not slacking. We are not going back. We are not retreating. We are not surrendering. In your presence, rest on. As we are celebrating our 30th of May today, we will declare there will be no more deaths. Instead of us to share our own blood, our enemies will pay with their own blood. Our enemies to pay. May the land of Biafra protect us. May the land of Biafra guide us. May the land of Biafra fight our enemies. Bullets, guns, we don't have. But we have Chukwuka Abiam. May the powers in heaven, may the powers on earth, the powers in water, may they rise at our defense. They fight for us. In the name of Chukwuka Abiam.
You have tribute to render. Please come forth with your tribute.
Yes.
Yeah,
Move on out.
Greetings, Biafrans, friends of Biafrans, and all the children of the rising sun. My name is Mem Michael Obina Ezajo. I am here to tell the world about Biafran children genocide. Biafran genocide is a very sad episode in the world history. This history episode has to be remembered by goodwill people. It should not be repeated in the world history, and Biafran genocide remains one of its black pages. It is widely known as Biafran genocide. You should understand it, that it is thought to be in the darkest page in the history of the nation. Plenty of people died, including children. However, everyone must remember about Biafran genocide to prevent it from happening again. Biafran region was the main source of oil for the whole Nigerian people and British government. They were afraid it would be taken away and their rights and needs would be neglected. On 6th July 1967, a Nigerian radio based in Kaduna has constantly broadcast before and after its main news program a war song in Hausa, which bears the following interpretation: "Let us go and crush them. We will take their properties, rape their women, murder their men, children, and complete the program of 1966. The Nigerian army added faithfully in this spirit of this war song: "We will shoot at everything that moves, and when our troops march in the center of Biafra territory, we will shoot at everything, even at things that does not move." Benjamin Adekunle, Commander 3rd Marine Commando Division, Nigerian Army. Numerous Biafran housewives and nursing mothers were raped before their husbands and children. Young girls were adopted from their homes and working place and schools and forced into sexual intercourse with sick Hausa Fulani men. 60 refugee camps contain about 700,000 of humans waiting hopelessly for a meal. Outside the camps, an estimated 4.5 to 5 million displaced persons. The question hit 1.5 million children suffered from it during January. Death toll at 300,000. Children more than the program of 1966, more than the war, more than the terror bombings. It was an obvious episode what helpless children waste and die. Several hundred of zombies like creatures, men, women and children were lying, sitting and squatting in the midst of others who were dead. The living ones were completely reduced to skeleton with diseases such as kwashiorkor. British and Nigerian military government act towards Biafran genocide. It is ugly and extreme that the British and Nigeria decided to stop the International Committee of the Red Cross and other relief agencies from flying fruit to Biafra. This led by Yakubu Gowa and late Bafemi Awolowo, leader of the Western region. Late Bafemi Awolowo, as the mastermind of British and Nigerian policy of blocking food shipments to Biafra. Mr. Awolowo admitted initiating the food policy, but said it was targeted at Biafra fighting personnel to help bring a war to a quick close. By Washington Post, July 2, 1969, the loss of life from starvation continued at more than 10,000 persons per day, over 1 million lives lost in months. Without emergency measures, the number went climbing to 25,000 per day within a month and some 2 million deaths by year. I, Michael Obinna Ezajo, belongs to those people, IPOB, who love peace and who are completely against all kinds of violence. I cannot understand those who kill the innocent people to achieve their purposes. A human life is a beauty of mankind, especially when it is considered the life of our children. I feel very sorry for such kind of political games with people's life. Especially, I feel deeply sorry for the innocent children because they have to grow up in love and peace, but no war and hunger. It is the responsibility of the World Union, UN, EU, AU, ICC, ICRC to stop these political games. Thanks.
Because that was our presentation on the commemoration.
1 hour!
Biafran kids, Obinna Ezajo, is 9 years old. And he's also a survivor and also a freedom fighter. At his age of 9, he's fighting for survivor and he's fighting for his nation, Biafra. Our fathers fought at within this age, right of age 67 to 70. On his age now, from the range of the indigenous people of Biafra, he's here also to join for the fight. And he's fighting against the children genocide that was carried on by the British Nigerians against the indigenous people of Biafra. Keep on watching.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending where you are at this time. This is a tribute to our fallen heroes by Igwacha Volunteer. Fellow citizens, the people of Igwacha, Biafra land, have by common impulse and consent adopted this day as a day of elegy and mourning. Today, there is silently and sadly borne to the grave by the whole Biafra nation many of our distinguished citizens, men, women, and children of the Republic who paid the utmost price for our freedom, examples of its beneficent institution. In 1967 to 1970, the attention of the whole world was directed to the genocidal war brought to Biafra people by the murderous Nigerian government led by arch genocidist General Yakubu Gowon. In every hour, death was entering that cottage, Biafra, and to every possession and every whisper, over 50 million of Biafra citizens were anxiously observing death coming close to them. But the whole world gave no meaningful attention to their suffering. But they watched as Biafrans are killed, murdered, humiliated, and held hostages in hundreds and thousands. Why this most profound and universal wickedness claimed over 6 million of the population of Biafran men, women, and children. The world was watching, but they did nothing. Death came to Biafra as to how he came to other nations like Rwanda, Israel, Vietnam, and other recognized genocide countries. The world must have interest in Biafra genocide. Biafrans waited patiently amid great suffering and calm amid transforming process that were taking place in their soul temporal tabernacle. while putting off the mortal apparel and dressing in the robe of immortality. No word of passion or complaint fell from their lips. They were forgetful of themselves, but very solicitous of the comfort and the happiness of their own people, and for the concordance and welfare of the whole Africa, and also humanity at large. Death is not opposite of life, but a part of it. We all die. That it will never come again is what makes life so sweet. It is not length of life, but depth of life. To the well-organized mind, death is but the next adventure. People living deeply have no fear. Rest on, our compatriots. Rest on, our gallant soldiers. Rest on, our heroes and heroines. We the living must make sure that we restore Biafra. So that all of us will live together again. Thanks, and remain resolute. Comrade Bryce, Chukwube Chukwu Onado, Devon.
Atama!
That was
Atama. The
presentation by the commander of Igocha Shack. Today is a great day to the life of Biafrans. Freedom fighters all over the world.
After Rugged, I'm here to read the biography of our late brother Yeshaya Miracle Udofia Udoite, aka Immortal. I read the late hero Yeshaya Miracle Udofia Udoite was born on 16 December 1996. At Igocha Military Hospital, Igocha Province. Miracle attended his Western education at the following places: Success Primary School, Rumosi, First School Living Certificate, 2002 to 2008, Command Army Day Secondary School, Rumola, Senior Secondary Certificate Examination, 2008 to 2014, turned on jovial. E.g., he fondly called his mother Mora, or his mother sister. He calls Auntie Jibebi. Obi, football reading, researching, making and listening to news on radio, especially Radio Biafra London, of which his mother noted that he was overly addicted to, beginning from late 2014 till his demisal on the 14th September 2017 at the Palace of Eze Kanu of Afara Uku Ibeku by the hands of Nigerian military attack. Vision or ambition. The hero Miracle Udofia Udoite was pregnant with the ambition of owning a charity organization, which he often retreat. Religion. To his mother, Grace Udofia Udoite, her son's early Christian religion involvement was acceptable to her than his later Yahudim religion. Dead. The late Yeshaya Miracle Udofia Udoite consciously chose a path of freedom fighting, in which he served as a volunteer to the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB. His active involvement and exhibition of overwhelming zeal and talent earned him a name which made him popular among the volunteers and to the entire IPOB family members by extension. Immortal, a name with various connotations. Finally, on 14 September 2017, he willingly gave back to nature that which was given to him in creation for the cause of freedom. He fought and died that you and I may have yeah, proper course of existence. From Rupa Kozun, Obiakpo, Area 1, Igocha Province. Iban, after Rugged.
That was a biography of falling hero, Udofia Miracle. He's Igbo speaking, Biafra. He was gone down on 24th of September 2017. The leader of the Jesus people, Biafra, the invasion, Nigerian military, so many of Biafra's youth, we are immortal by his fellow comrades for the state. These are the Igwechan Sharks, honoring the foreign heroes.
All right, Biafra.
All right, Biafra.
Biafra.
Freedom.
I'm here to read the biography of John Richard Ogbonna Osuchi. Was born on 20th July 1993. A native of Amini, Omopo, Uwori, Agwa, Autonomous Community, Uguta, LGA, Imo State. He was a hardcore loyal follower of the struggle for freedom in Igwecha, Biafra land, under the leadership of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He was lost and not yet found since 30th May 2016 on the prayer rally at Mpo, Anambra State, Biafra land. He was working as an assistant manager at Sobas Oil Station, Eleme Junction, Port Harcourt, Igwecha, and he also owned a poultry of not less than 2,000 birds. He is a hard IPOB security personnel that he avoided everything to see the freedom of Biafra or the Ohe
Biafra.
Ohe
Biafra.
IPOB.
One family.
Beri si beje laya.
Beri wa yoma.
That's a biography of
Beri
si beje laya.
Beri wa yoma.
CG, he works also
at
a time of the President on 13th May 2016 on the prayer that he was occupied. And also to date, today, remembering him also. This Igwecha Sharks, honoring our foreign heroes.
The patriot, the national sovereignty, a tribute to the late immortal. Our nation, our toll, without flesh in pain service, redent in relish of soul. With blood of our face, in sacrifice extension, dear fallen hero, you are defeated to be trapped not as a soldier, but as a patriot. In our dedication to our great nation, when my fellow zombies and you draw our pride in trash of loyalty to our imminent state, being transparent in death, yet you shall be reckoned as a patriot. Like a drop of scarlet on white and forbid was suited with blood. In death, it is life in purity, often to our freedom, for certain you well as a wall of fabricate. Striving vigorously in distant foot of action against the sovereignty of our dear nation. And like a defrayed, you stood in the gentility collection with the force up to the climax. Consequence. Championing the cause like a warrior while you stood in gap for the states. Oh, how allegiance, it seems, yet it empirical fact daily devastated in our heart with an indeflectable mark of impression. Sincerely, your demands, even your own demands, oh dear patriot of our rising sun, have created an irrecognizable vacuum communally in our subconscious. Here, oh, our fallen heroes who have equipped his name, oh God, the pledge of our living comrade, isn't in debt in combat on us to finish the course you champion. Because it itches our heart to assure the safety of our nation, sovereignty, when in our father's land we shall stand in the boldly victory of our heroes and patriots, reading on the sovereignty of our state with our banner of honor and dignity, waving to year for freedom given, yet the immortal shall be immortalized in the subsequently of positive as a legend and in our heart as a patriot, when we shall pause the world of battle to heal, then shall we remember those who in mass died for our freedom. Then, just then, our trumpet peal the victorious song of victory, we scroll over mighty and raw. Latof Yeshua Maraka Udofia, aka the immortal stuff. Shalom, O dear Petra.
What are on away my eye? What are on away my eye? What are on away my eye? What are on away my eye?
What are on away my eye?
When I remember immortal, what are on away my eye?
What are on away my eye?
Pray! Stand eyes!
Stand easy. Van out.
Yes. One of us started a song to render to our father's voice. And I said, let's sing a little bit.
My soul says, we will never, 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 we will never forget. We will never, 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 we will never forget them. We will never, 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 we will never forget 3.5 million Biafran killed in the war. I will say Meganyaro, Riti Gomente Megani, Lego Baro Maninete, Vengeance, Vengeance. I will say Meganyaro, Riti Gomente Megani, Lego Baro Maninete, Vengeance, Vengeance. Obara John, Obara John, Ugona Netie, Obara Himota Netie, Leko Baraha Netie, Vengeance, Vengeance, Obara Umanyi Netie, Mbem Teta Yemene Na Ukwoe, Tie Were Yie Tie, Woe Woe, Leko Obara Umanyi Netie, Vengeance, Vengeance, Leko Baruma Ninete, Vengeance, Vengeance. Oh, 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 only Biafra, take your Nigeria, give us Biafra, Biafra must be free. Oh, 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 only Biafra, take your Nigeria,
Nigeria, give us Biafra, Biafra must be free. On the 20th of January, I was there present. The blood of Biafra flowed like a river on the streets of Biafra land. On the 30th of May, 2016, the blood of Biafra flowed like a river on the streets of Biafra land. On the 9th of February, 2016, the blood of Biafra flowed like a river on the streets of Biafra land. On the 14th of September, in Afari Bekwe, the blood of Biafra flowed like a river on the Only Biafra, take your Nigeria, give up Biafra, Biafra must be free. Oh, only Biafra, take your Nigeria, give up Biafra, Biafra must be free. The forgotten British company, call Nigeria. Nigeria is a terrorizing Biafras every day by day. Nigeria is a killer killing Biafras every day by day. Indigenous people are Biafra. I be we have bad head and wait for prison. Biafra order for whatever. Baba never. Biafra must be free. Oh. Only Biafra. I cry every day when I see my people dying. I cry every day when I see my people suffering. Nigeria say we are one, they are killing us every day. They say we are one, they are killing us every day. They say we are one, we don't have freedom of assembly. They say we are one, we don't have freedom of expression. Our cultures are not the same. Our religion are not the same. We are not one. I can never, never, never be one. No retreat, no surrender. We are voting for Biafra. No retreat, no surrender. We are voting for Biafra. Adakabori was killed by Nigeria. Kesaro Wiwa was killed by Nigeria. Major General Agunrosi was killed by Nigeria. Lieutenant Colonel Wilfred Udemba was killed by Nigeria. The injustice is so much. The hatred is alarming. No retreat, no surrender. We are voting for Biafra. No retreat, no surrender. We are voting for Biafra.
Teach us that first song, the first one.
Strangers.
Yes.
Yeah, this song was presented by our sister Favour Azu. She's presented the songs to just like a tribute songs to the Biafran's Falling Heroes.
We will never
the second Biafran's and the four talents.
I will say Megana
songs for our fallen heroes. Biafra's are formidable. Biafra's are gallant.
Never, 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 we will never forget, we will never, 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 we will never forget. 3.5 million Biafra killed during the war. I will say Meganya Lu. Pretty comment in Meganya Lu. Let go of a Roman.
Vengeance, vengeance.
I will say Meganya Lu. Pretty comment in Meganya Lu. Let go of a Roman.
Vengeance, vengeance.
Never, 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 never. We will never forget. 3.5 million Biafran killed during the war. We will never, 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 we will never forget. 3.5 million Biafran killed during the war. I will say Meganya Lu. Pretty comment in Meganya. Let go of our own man.
Vengeance, vengeance.
Pretty comment in Meganya. Let go of our own man.
What you're watching is Biafran Fallen Heroes and Heroes Memorial Ceremony parade by Ugo Charles Sharp. I've been to the 30th May of known as Biafran's
want to use this opportunity to send this unmistakable message to Nigerian government, to British government, to all the nation, all the countries that are supporting Nigerian government. We are not violent people. We are not criminals. We are not kidnappers. We are not so-called terrorists. We are indigenous people of Biafra. We are fighting for our freedom. We know that it is enshrined in the UN Charter that every people have their right for self-determination. But it's a pity that the world have turned blind eyes on the freedom and affliction of Biafrans. We have gotten to our own case, and now the world is diplomatical. They are choosing the law to obey and the ones not to obey. But we are telling them right now, this 2019 May celebration, we are telling them that if they are thinking or if they are contemplating that in one way or the other, we are going to stop to champion our freedom, let them be rest assured that they will wait for eternity.
Yeah.
We the children of those people they murdered, more than 6 million they murdered. They murdered our mothers. They murdered women. They murdered us. I was killed during that time. But lo and behold, I have reconnected. And I'm here to take revenge. Be the children of those my mothers have come back to reclaim, have come back to take our freedom. By or by force. This time around, we are not begging them. We have done it before. We fought them for 3 years without any weapon. We fought them for 3 years. We withstood them. No matter their collaborations, Egyptian pilots, USSR, Britain, America, even America, and all the whole nation that support Nigeria, we fought them. If our heroes and heroines, our ancestors, can withstood them for 3 years, in this generation, we will withstood them forever.
Yes,
let's tell them, let the whole world know, we are not asking people's land. We are not asking Yoruba their land. We are not dragging the land of Funanis. We are not dragging the land of Osas. Simple thing we are asking is we want to live the way nature has made us. We want to inhabit the land of our ancestors. We want to be free. We want to live like a free people. We want to have freedom of expression. We want to have freedom of speech. We want to have freedom of association. We want to have freedom to choose what to worship. Because Biafra represents freedom. Let the whole world support us. Let the whole world support us. Let them not mind the bribe the Nigerian government is giving to them. The so-called money, the so-called bribe the Nigerian government is giving to you is being collected from our land. But we are not fighting. We are not fighting because of the oil. We are not fighting because of the resources. We are fighting because of freedom. Because we are not free. The British government have subjected us as a second class or third class citizen to uncircumcised Hausa Fulani. And that is why we need freedom. We want to live as a free people. Oil can stay. Resources can stay. It is not our problem. There are some countries that don't have oil. They are surviving.
Yes,
there are some countries that don't have even human and natural resources we have. But they are surviving. We will survive without oil.
Yes,
we will make it without oil.
Yes,
oil is not the issue. Before oil was discovered, our ancestors not living.
Yeah.
Our ancestors not better than many of our Fulani people.
Yeah.
Before the evil British government came here and amalgamated us. Amalgamated us. Two different people. Two different entities. Oil and war. They force us, subjugate us by gun and by bullets for us to be one entity for the purpose of their business. They did not amalgamate Nigeria for our own goods. They did not amalgamate Nigeria to help us, to bring our potentials, to educate us, to make us to go heaven. They came here for business. They came here solely for purpose of business. They came here to express us. They came here to take what rightfully belongs to us. They got it. But instead of leaving us the way they saw us, they committed the worst crime in human race. They amalgamated two different people in religion, in culture, in language, in everything you can think of. Because of material thing, because of material wealth, because of oil and gas, they force us, whether we like it or not, we will be part of this unlawful union. But today, we, the children of those that they murdered, have come back again to make sure that nature will take its course. This time around, we are telling the world, if they like, let them support them again. But we are telling them that when you are pointing somebody with one hand, the rest is pointing at you. Anything you are doing to us, be it any nation, America, you said you are world power. Listen to me. Britain, you are claiming you are strong. Israel, all the whole nation, you are claiming you are this, you are that. Listen to me. If you people go against Biafra, watch, your land will be destroyed. The power that be, the power that rule the whole world, will destroy any nation. Any people that are supporting evil. Today, as we honor our hero, we wake them up. All the souls, all the spirits that are murdered unjustly. Today, we are commissioning them. We are renewing their strength. We are sending them message to go and trouble our troublers. To go and kill our killers. To go and kill the supporters of our killers. Whatever they are. If America wants to live as a free people, if they still want to be world power, let them support the emergence of Biafra. Any nation that wants to be great, let them support the emergence of Biafra. Because Biafra will make Africa great. Biafra will make Africa great. The emergence of Biafra will make Africa great. Let African countries, EU, all of them should come together and make sure that we have our freedom. Because all of them will benefit from it. All of them will be benefit. Every country will be benefit. Biafra will be a blessing to all African countries. But if they refuse, if they work against Biafra emerges, we must have our freedom. But to let them be rest assured that they will be destroyed. We are not threatening them. But we are attending the word of the Most High. This is the word of the Most High, and the Most High have commissioned us to come and restore his kingdom here on earth. They have the choice. They have the choice whether to support Biafra or not. But we have the choice to fight for our freedom, whether they like it or not. My fellow comrades, men and women here today, urge each and every one of us to remain resolute. What can separate you from the love of Biafra?
Nothing.
Is it prison?
No.
Is it I'm police station?
No.
Is it death?
No.
Is it hunger?
No.
Is it a wife?
No.
Is it a house of your relative?
No.
Is it money?
No.
What can you give in exchange of your freedom?
Nothing.
What can you give in exchange of your freedom?
Nothing.
Biafra or
death.
Our leader says, either we will restore Biafra or our bodies are lowered. I support him 100%. I support him 100%. And also, we want to use this opportunity to send message to our leader, Mazin Amerikano. Wherever never him contemplate, never him look back. We, the volunteers of Ugo Chai, are behind him. We are solidly behind him. Even though it may be one person that I hear, that person must support him. All the directors of says, anybody that are working earnestly, that are working in truth and in honesty for Biafra restoration. Wherever you are, this is the sound of the great shock of you coming to life. We are asking you never you relent. We are asking you never you surrender. We are asking you never you think twice. The freedom of your people. Something you can after your education. The only thing you can offer us, your people, after all your civilization, after your, all your exposure, after all your money, is freedom.
Yes, sir.
You,
sir?
You may have the whole world. You may travel the whole countries. You may be exposed. You may be eating and dining with Trump. You may be eating and dining with any president of any world power. But if you do not work for our freedom, you are lost.
Yes, sir.
And also, we are telling our so-called elders, Ohanaeze Ndigbo, and all cultural group in Biafra land, this is not time to sit at the fence. This is not time to apportion blame. Our elders is threatened. Our elders is ask question mark now. This is not time to know who is doing this. When you see a moving vehicle heading towards your direction, what are you going to do?
Join.
Is it not to join that moving train?
Yes.
Yes. There may be 1,000 trains yet to move, but you have seen one that is moving towards your destination. Common sense demands that you join. We are asking our brothers and sisters, even our saboteurs, those that are sabotaging our struggle, those that are selling us, because we know that no one can do it. We know that what is doing us is inside us.
Yes.
We know that the problem is from our people. Disunity, envy, pride, greed, power tussle, selfishness. You are there dragging. I am this, I am that. Your mother is being killed by Funani Hesman. You are that dragon. I am this, I am that. Your village is being overrun. Are you all foolish?
You are foolish.
We are telling you this is not the time to reckon. This is not the time to say I am this, I am that. Until all of us emancipate ourselves from this slavery, then you will count the cost. This is not the time to count the cost. Let our brothers and sisters, those that are living in diaspora, let them not play with our struggle. Let them not play with our freedom, because we are not going to spare them.
Yes, sir.
We are here collecting the bullets. We are here facing all manner of charges, all manner of intimidations. And they are there quarreling, and they are there talking nonsense. Let me tell them, if they are not, you are joking, we are here waiting for them.
Yes.
Agratamos,
come on.
Let them know that we are here watching them.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Anything they are doing there, we are the ones that are suffering it. And we are not going to take it lightly with them.
Yes.
If they thought that after doing that, nothing will happen. Nothing will happen only when they remain in that place. When they die and they bury them in that place. But as long as they step in here, they step in their foot here in this blessed land, we will host them.
Yes.
We will look for them.
Yes.
We will kill them.
Yes.
They will suffer the way we are suffering.
Yes.
This message is for us, brothers. Those that are sabotaging this struggle. Those that are sabotaging this struggle. It is high time. It is high time. It is high time. It is high time. It is high time they should reason. It is high time they should wake up. It is high time they will place value on the price of the price of our fallen heroes. Our heroes are in the price they pay. The price they pay. And I know the only thing that is hindering Biafra not to come is disunity. We ourselves, I call on Biafra population. I call on men and women of Biafra. This is time to join hands. This is time to follow the moving trend. IPOB!
IPOB! IPOB!
IPOB is the moving trend.
Yes.
Come on,
joy.
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 We don't run.
Before I
do,
great speech from the legal sharks. Presentation the parade ceremony of our foreign heroes. At this moment, we'll be shutting down. We urge you, dear friends, over the world to keep sharing to the enemies of Biafra, and we should also to remain resolute and keep on supporting the Supreme Leader of Indigenous People of Biafra, Prince Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, to keep supporting him.
People. We are going higher. We are going higher.